Welcome everybody, welcome. Keep coming in everyone, keep coming in. Those of you just coming at the back, give us a wave.
We have 7 Christmas trees around the hall at the moment, including an enormous 25 foot tall one right down the end. These Christmas trees are a little bit of a team effort from the filmmakers. So each one of the ornaments you can see adorning the trees was actually designed by the art department, then made by the props team, then put onto the trees by the set decorators. And finally, right at the top, you can see those spinning witches going around the trees. These were added by the special effects department as they felt a little bit left out of the process. Now, it wouldn't be Christmas at Hogwarts without a nice lavish feast, so you can see we've laid the feast out for you. Over on the right-hand side, as you make your way in, we have our main course. Now, come over and take a look. It all looks very, very delicious, but I would not recommend trying to eat any of it. It's all entirely fake. It's made of material called plastic resin. That doesn't tell the whole story, though. When we first started filming for the Harry Potter series, we were cooking fresh food every day, bringing it out on the set. We realised pretty quickly, though, this was a terrible idea, because all the kids were eating as much food as they possibly could straight away, feeling a bit sick for the rest of the day. But the bigger problem was, we were leaving fresh food out under hot studio lights, and that meant it all went off pretty quickly and started smelling quite bad. So, in the end, we transitioned and started using the fake pot food you can see in front of you here instead. But if you're anything like me, when it comes to Christmas dinner, the best part isn't the main course, it's all about the dessert. I love a bit of Christmas pudding. And what I'm going to do is send you over to the table on the opposite side where my friend Ray is waving at you just now. Now she's going to be showing you a special effect in just a moment. So head on over to the table, fill up the whole length of the table. You'll be able to see this effect all the way down the length of the table. Get your phones and your cameras out, pop them on video mode, get them recording. And then last thing to do, take a little step back away from the barrier for me. And in 3, 2, 1, fantastic. Those are our flaming Christmas puddings. Now they've been rigged with a special effect to make real flames engulf those puddings, but I think the coolest thing about them is what they're made out of. Believe it or not, those puddings are made entirely of concrete, and on the top we have holly, which is made of steel to withstand the heat. Thank you so much, Ray. Now we are going to move on to our 4 famed Hogwarts houses. So starting over on this side at my left, we have Hufflepuff House, or is it Umbridge? On the same side of the room, but opposite me this time, we have Ravenclaw House. In the centre there, the robes of Moaning Myrtle, the ghost of the girl's bathroom. Yes, she was indeed a Ravenclaw for her untimely demise. And finally, right down the end on my side over here, we have the house of our heroes. I'm of course talking about Gryffindor. And right down the end, a very, very special costume indeed. Now this is Harry Potter's very first set of Gryffindor robes. Daniel Radcliffe wore these in Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone when he was just 11 years old. It's complete with his little Gryffindor tie and his teeny tiny wizard hat, and I think you'll all agree, it is rather adorable. Now following all the way to the top this time, so just like Harry, Ron and Hermione did on their first day at Hogwarts, you've taken the same journey. So you've come through the big doors, right up the centre aisle to the top table, and this right here is where they would have been sorted in front of some of Britain's finest acting talent. Now speaking of which, I'm sure you could all tell me who the big guy over here is. This is of course Rubius Hagrid, as played in the films by the actor Robbie Coltrane. But I'm about to let you in on your first big secret of the day, and that is that Robbie Coltrane never wore this costume. Now he is quite a tall man. Robbie is 6'2". That's not tall enough to play a half giant. So this is actually the costume of his body double. Now, the man we chose for that job is called Martin Bayfield. He's actually an ex-England rugby player, and he's very tall. He stands at 6'10", but that's still not quite big enough to play a half giant. So we had to give him a little bit of a helping hand. We added stilts in his shoes. We then padded the costume out to make him nice and big. But the best thing we did was we built him a giant fake animatronic head that looked exactly like Robbie Coltrane's face. So when Martin was wearing this suit here with that head on top, he not only looked exactly like Hagrid, but he now stood at a huge 7'6", which is finally big enough to play our giant. And you'll get to see how those animatronic heads later on in our creatures workshop, still talking and blinking away. But for now, everyone, your time in the Great Hall will come to an end shortly, but there's one or two things you need to know before you head off, as the rest of the way will be self-guided. So first of all, if anybody has a digital guide with the green lanyards and the headphones, your tour stops just through the archways there. You're looking for circular numbered icons to take you around today. Number one will be directly opposite you if you exit through the right-hand archway. And the next tour ends in the Great Hall, and then going all the way up to the top table. That would be absolutely
Thank you. That's okay, we've just been past that one. effects had to do the CG version, which you see get a background. The special effects and the visual effects have to overlap, particularly in the realms of Harry Potter. We're in a magical world, and a lot of that magic has to be created by the visual effects and the CGI guys. But we're there to put the real. Most of the job was
go that far!
Watch where you're going to sleep. Look, the man is in front of you.
That's nice.
Yeah, the other thing they do, pretty random, is when you are part of the